content of my presentation. In the beginning, I would like to pay your attention about the main question, main problem we should to answer. What want to do in our experiments, and what we want. I think the main idea to obtain and study the interaction between the hydrogen atoms, maybe hydrogen ions, with the nanocluster metals. According well-known results obtained in Japan and Russia, the cross-section of this reaction between the heavy atoms and ions with small energy, about 100 electron volts, but maybe 1,000 kilovolts, it's very bad statistics about these results, and today there is a problem to obtain the reliable results of the cross section between of this reaction. And so many of the presentation devoted to the, for example, Iwamura said that it's not chemical reaction, it's intermediate zone between the chemical energy and the nuclear energy. This 1,000 electron volts range of the energy release, it's very interesting, it's understandable, and up to today we have no real machine who used power generators on this range, KEF energy. But KEF energy, it's well known that connected with the internal electron inside of atoms. And many of the experimental results, for example, Karabut Alexander showed that there are soft X-ray radiation during this type of the reaction. And according to my opinion, there are two main approaches to in linear physics: thermal equilibrium, for example, Iwamura and Parkhomov Alexander, Rossiya and others use namely this approach. And non-thermal, non-equilibrium, for example, Bajutov Yuri, Mills Ronald, and myself tried to use electrical discharge, plasma formation, for the obtaining of the stable, real experimental results in this direction. And here you see only thermal heating. What's thermal heating? It's excitation energy less than 1 eV. But in the when we have plasma formation, charged, strongly charged formation, it's, for example, cathode region, it's no problem to obtain ions with 100 electron volts. And so high efficiency of the our reaction, high CRP, and in our results we have reliable value of this CRP about 10, and today we have 20. It's maximal value of CRP. Here, simple design. Here, not simple design and expensive power supply and heat transformers, calorimeters, and many of the channel of the losers, for example, very powerful thermal radiation and safety. It's dangerous for the health I think it's small, but here it's problem. And many of my members of my team have a problem with their health. For example, Yuri Bajutov now is a hospital. And why? Because of nanoparticles is very difficult to see. And the breathing of these nanoparticles and all these particles sources of the soft X-ray radiation and problem of the cancer. It's a real problem. Our immunity is decreases constantly during this experiment. What is plasmoids? It's not plasma. It's stable, local, non-equilibrium, strongly charged, non-neutral. Long-living, high-energy plasma formation. You can see formation in this high-frequency discharge, ball plasmoid, absolutely different color. Here you see blue, and this is yellow and red. And here you see powerful microwave discharge, filamentary types, very, very complex structure. And it's real characteristics obtained in the plasmoid physics now, today. You see this some of the example of these plasmoids. It's high frequency plasmoids over water surface. It's erosion plasma ball lightning, like ball lightning created by the pulse repetitive generators arranged in the water. And I would like to pay your attention about very interesting possibility to combine plasma and nanoparticles. Very interesting features, peculiarities of this interaction. Why? Electron temperature, typical electron temperature in the plasmoid, about one electron volts. And if you have a small cluster about nano size, it's very simple to show that the de Broglie electron wave, meta wave, is close to the diameter of this cluster. So we have possibility to realize resonance regime of the interaction of the electron flux from the plasma to the these clusters. And in this case, we have a real possibility to create strongly electrical charge plasmoid with a high electrical potential. And other peculiar other features of namely hydrogen atoms. It's well known that compared to the other ions, the size of these ions very small. It's proton. It's maybe factor four smaller than the other type of the ions. So it's very easy to penetrate these particles inside of the heavy atoms. And if we have high atoms about KeV energy, it's easy to realize interaction of the internal electrons and heavy metal atoms. It's very interesting work prepared Gurevich Pogorelsky from the IOFI Institute, Russian Academy of Science, B-nuclear atom. It's a theoretician dream, but estimation, but for me, it's very interesting that in this work was shown that there is existence of the bound state of the proton and the heavy atoms, for example, near the SK orbits of the internal electron. Background. Former Soviet Union, it's well-known results, many of efforts was done for the creation of the powerful microwave weapons. It's using microwave radiation in the high altitude of the atmosphere. We tried to realize microwave plasmoid for the military purposes. And so in this researches we obtained that artificial microwave plasmoid was obtained the first time Peter Kapitsa, and main his results was the following: increase of the output UV radiation and soft X-ray radiation up factor 1 million times. It's increased this flux UV radiation during the threshold diffuse plasma to the constricted plasmoid state. And so experiment with the microwave fire was done in former Soviet Union and proved this conclusion. This phenomena was named UV catastrophe in the stable microwave plasmoid. Ronald Mills also calculated and measured UV and the X-ray radiation. And now we have a situation in the world when the infrared fire was changed to the UV fire, and new Prometheus fire will be used in the chemistry and the energetic. It's a real measurement of the Mills, and you see this is a soft main part of the radiation of this plasmoid is concentrated namely in the soft X-ray radiation. And we have a patent to our effective plasma vertex reactor. And maybe some of these colleagues took part in the PADE conference, and some of these results were presented in this conference. Many of the experimental results using high frequency discharge with erosive metal nanoclusters were in our previous works, and the typical value was CIP. And now all experimental results prove that the high threshold chemical reactions with the internal electron excitation by combined discharge, it's possible inside of these plasmoids, and maybe low energy nuclear reaction possible also. It's our main works. With the study of the plasma tornado, vertex plasmoid. It's a very interesting direction, but it's... the main part of my presentation is connected with the consideration of the plasmoid vertex reactor, and you see this vertex generator. It's a mechanical injector, tangential injection of the gas, and so we have rotated flow inside of the quartz tube, and here you see discharge area, anode and cathode, and some of the thermocouple. We use some of the thermocouple, three of here and here and here, to control of the heating of the all elements of experimental setup. Значит, here you see the vertical position of the our reactor. Here cathode, anode, and this vertical reactor is arranged in the water pool. Water pool was a calorimeter of our. We measure the excess of the energy by means of this calorimeter, and we calibrate this system ordinary ohmic electrical ohmic heater, the same size, the same power, the same like plasma formation. And the typical parameters of our experiments. And you see the creation of many, many of the erosion particles near the cathode. And here we inject water steam. And high-speed camera, you see the creation of many, many multi-plasmoid system and micro droplets, metal droplets ejected from the cathode area. We measure that this plasmoid strongly charged, and creation of new elements connected, namely, is this plasmoid. Electrodes were made from the nickels, and here you see the typical erosion process in the cathode area, and it's very important for me that transmutation of the elements connected, namely with these holes, craters, and you see the some of these microparticles which drifted from the cathode to anode. And it's no problem to estimate the against airflow. And it's another method to measure electrical charge potential of this droplet. It's very interesting picture, but I have no time. And we measure the main results of the erosion processes, the metal lost in our nickel electrode, about milligram per second, and additional extra power obtained in the this reactor was about 3 kilowatts. We can divide here, and it's very simple to obtain specific heat power. It's value about 1,000 electron volts per atom metal, or maybe recalculated to the hydrogen. It's very interesting to important to note that the water steam dissociated in the plasma area, and vertex centrifuge vertex separation help to concentrate hydrogen atom in the axis of this reactor and obtain the flux of the energy of the hydrogen ions, and namely in near cathode area. And you see another realization of experiment with the passive electrodes, longitudinal discharge. It's for me, it's very interesting to show you that in the beginning of the operation of this reactor, you see dissociating process of the water steam, ash, creation of the hydrogen atom, OH, and then we see another elements, for example, potassium, kalium, and it's stable mode of the operation mode of this reactor, about 1 minute, and you see that the typical continuous spectrum connected with the metal nanoclusters, and the hydrogen atom is absolutely absent, and in this regime, no hydrogen atoms. And some of the words about key experiments in the input of this reactor we use safety water steam, not hydrogen, helium, argon, and nickels. And output we observe in our optical spectrum lithium, kalium, cuprum, zincum. And you see the, for example, realization when we use argon, and if this reaction is possible, you very easy to explain this line of the kalium in our experiments. If you see change argon to the helium, helium plus hydrogen, it's a predictable creation of the lithium, and you see the line of the lithium, lithium, and when we change once more argon, you see that no lithium, but hydrogen, only hydrogen and kalium. And we have another possibility to use helium, and when nickels plus helium, we predicted result will be a creation of the zincum. And many of the zincum lines were observed during this experiment, and it's very interesting that high excited zincum with, for example, zincum 2, were created in this experiment. About X radiation, we measure soft X radiation, and also different methods, independent method, two types. It's American X-ray spectrometer, and Russian. And main results are the following. There is two pipes connected like a Karabut experiment. The first pipe is located near 1 keV, and the second about 5 keV. Another type of the spectrometer obtained the same results, 5, 0, 1. And very interesting, when we cross-section of the registration can change from the nozzle of this reactor. Here, this gas flow. And you see the excitation of the surround area, for example, nitrogen lines, then oxygen lines, but in this section, oxygen is double line you see, and beginning of the formation of the fluorine line, and in this section only fluorine. In ordinary air, fluorine is absent. It's very interesting results also. Oh, okay, I have no time, and so for example, ion mass spectrometry of nanoparticles collected in the water cool colorimeter is presented here, and you see in the chemical composition Nicholas initial Nicholas electrode used here, and many of the other chemical elements, for example, many of the cuprum like Rossi, Andrea Rossi experiment, and it's okay. And this conclusion of my presentation, the following. Binuclear atom, I think it's possible because of intensive X-ray radiation less than 10 keV in heterogeneous plasmoid there is. Hadrina. Maybe this hypothesis also very useful because of we have the typical second peak 4 keV, but the Compton energy of the hadrina states about 3.7 keV. CIP and there is CIP and X-ray radiation correlation. When the maximum of X-ray radiation we have obtained a maximum value of CIP. And also without nanoclusters it's impossible to obtain stable and higher value of this CIP. And also very interesting that the new atoms usually obtained with a high excitated state. You see the excitation energy of these two elements, but the main value of this excitation elements were measured in the lithium impurity in our reactor. And very reliable results we obtained with the specific power about 1 keV per atom. Thank you for your